Come As You Are by Nirvana, an absolute cracker of a song. I'm sure you'll agree. That is why you're here. That is why you want to learn the drums to it. So, let's get started right now. All right, so this song starts with guitar. It's got that cool, eerie guitar line. And then we come in on and for end. If you're thinking, what the hell's and for end? I'll count it out for you. And what we're going to be doing on and for end is right hand on the floor, left hand on the middle tom or high tom if you don't have a middle tom. And it's going to be two hits and then one hit just on the floor tom. Evenly spaced though, so it'll sound like this. All right. So you're going to hear the guitar line, then you're going to hear me saying one and two and three and four and. And again, one and two and three and four and. Now from what I can hear on the track, there is no kick drum being played there. The kick comes in on one at the start of that verse. Okay, so after we play that, go straight into the verse. One and two and three and four and. One and two and three and four and. Right, let's hear that little drum intro in context. You ready? One, two, three and four and. Again? Why not? Let's just listen to it again. It's quite fast. And four and. One and two and three and four and. So once we played that little and four and drum fill on the toms, we're in with the verse beat. It's the first verse of the song and it is played on the ride cymbal. All right. So have a look at the drum notation below. You'll be able to see the kick pattern, which goes like this. One. Two and three and four and kick. Kick, 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 kick. Alright, so it's kick, 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 kick. Alright, so one to start it, then there's a two, and then there's a three. So it's an easy way to remember the grouping. Otherwise, just look at the notation if you prefer to read sheet music. All right, so now I'm going to play that groove nice and slowly again. And you're going to try and play along if you have sticks, if you're behind your drum set. If not, just soak it in and try and get the feel of this groove. One and two and three and four and. Kick. Kick, 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 kick. So after that verse, we go to pre-chorus number one. So there is two different variations of the pre-chorus, which I'll explain later. It's just the last part, okay? That's a little hint. But pre-chorus number one sounds like this, nice and slowly. And it's played on quarter notes on the crash. So one, two, three, four, okay? Nice swiping of the cymbals to get that full sound. Here we go. One and two and three and four and. Two, three, four. One, two, three, and four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, and four. One. All right, so there's a couple of tricky parts about this pre-chorus. The first one is there is a kick on the offbeat on three and, so the end of three. One, two, Hear that? Three and. So you're going to need to kick as your stick is up in the air after that three. Three and. So if you need to practice that, you can literally just zoom in on that part. Three and four. Three and four. Three and four. Let's create a little practice loop for yourself until you get really comfortable doing those kicks. And something I find really helps is to pretend that stick is hitting a drum up here, which funnily enough sounds just like a kick drum. Okay, so when your stick's about here, you want to hear that kick drum sound again. One, two, three, four. Or to count that is 2E and a, 3E and a, 4E and a. All right. So that is just accenting the very first hit. Whether you're a right-hander or a left-hander, you're accenting the first of each four hits, and there's three groupings of four. One, 2E and a, 3E and a, 4E and a. Now with those accents, you want to make those with the accents, they want to be obviously as loud as you can make them, but don't tense up. You don't have to hit as hard as you can and clench your fists. You just want to give a bit more airtime to your stick and a lot less airtime to those other three hits, all right? We want to exaggerate how small they are. So the pre-chorus does four rounds, and the fourth round sounds like this. There's a bit of a fill, a very cool fill, actually, at the end. All right? So I'm going to jump straight to the fourth repetition of this pre-chorus. Here we go. And again. So it's four hits on the snare, two hits on tom 2 or tom 1, if you don't have tom 2, one hit on floor, then when you lift your hand off the floor, you're going to have a kick all by itself, while your hand's in the air, and then end with a killer flam. So the fill starts on 3, on 2, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, four hits on the snare, two up here, one on the floor. Alright, so to play verse number two, you are going to do exactly what you did in verse number one, except it is shorter. There will be a play along, and it'll say how many bars remaining, okay, in the corner of the screen. So you will be able to just see that countdown of how many bars you have to go before it changes into the next section. Alright, so moving on, let's learn pre-chorus number two. Pre-chorus two is exactly the same as pre-chorus one, except instead of that awesome fill at the end, I'm sorry, you only get to play that fill once in this song. Damn you, Growly! Instead of that, we're just going to go flam kick, flam kick, flam kick, flam kick, which is, in my opinion, just as awesome. The more flams, the merrier, I say. All right, so in context, this is how the pre-chorus is going to sound. Pre-chorus two. One and two and three and four and one, two, three and four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three and four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three and four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three and four. One, two, three, four. So in pre-chorus one, our fill came in on two. These flams are just coming in on one, okay?
Three and four. One, two, three, four. No,
chorus groove. All right. Now this has got a really nice open hi-hat sound, nice thick sizzle, because the song elevates at this point. So Dave Grohl opens up his hi-hats about there, and you control that with your foot. You just lift your foot a little bit off, just relax that foot a bit, and allow those hi-hats to open. So it's not like that. That's what we want. Now, these, just like the pre-chorus, are going to be quarter notes. Now, you can play a molar technique if you want, a bit of a push-pull, which I have a video for, so check it out if you're not sure what the hell a molar technique is. But for now, we're going to do quarter notes, all right? But this is how the whole chorus sounds, okay? So have a listen to where those crashes are landing, and they're also written there in the drum notation, which you can look at below if you wish. Here we go. One. And two, and three, and four, and... So that last hit there was the one, okay? So there's, he does four repeats in the chorus. And yeah, you'll notice the kick pattern is kick, kick, snare, kick, kick, snare. Now, if you're not comfortable still doing those kicks on the offbeat, just zoom in and slow them right down. Kick, kick, both. Kick, kick, both. It is the same as what's happening in the pre-chorus on three and. One and two. And three and three and. So we're just moving our arm over on the hats. And we're doing the kick, kick every single time. So now I'm going to play the, well, let's call it the breakdown. It's the groove that sets up that guitar solo entry. But when the guitars do come in, the groove just keeps going, all right? So I'm just going to play the last couple of bars of the breakdown, then I'll show you how it goes into the pre-chorus, then after that, it goes back into the chorus, all right? Here we go. One, and two, and three, and four, and... Ready? And four and one and two and three and four. Then, after that chorus is played, you're just rocking out again on that breakdown beat. Alright, right until the end of the song. And at the very end of the song, he does this... snare, snare, crash, crash, crash. Come As You Are by Nirvana. I'm Matt from Crutopia Drums, and I really hope you've enjoyed this video, and I hope you now know how to play, and you can play along with me in my other play-along videos that I've got going. All right, have a great, amazing rest of your day/night.